Anticipation is one of the most important animation principles. It helps to prepare for what's about to happen, the action before the main action. Like, we all know what's about to happen. You can also play with it and do the opposite of what we think is going to happen. Like, you didn't expect me to change for every word. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, by the way. Let's animate this happily bouncing ball until we break it into pieces. I've already added a new comp and a background solid with a radial gradient ramp. Next, let's add a floor. With no layer selected, we double click on the rectangle tool. Let's name the shape layer floor. Next, we open the rectangle one path property or use the properties we know to change the size. We deactivate constraint proportions and set the size to 1920 by 2 pixels. No stroke. Let's use a solid fill color. White. It looks like a line, but actually is a shape. Next, let's position it. We open the position property, press P, and move it down to Y900 pixels. For a bouncing ball animation, we need a ball, obviously. So with no layer selected, we choose the ellipse tool and double click on it. Let's name this shape layer sphere or ball. We adjust the size again, deactivate constraint proportions and set the size to 150 by 150 pixels. Let's use a radial gradient as fill this time. We choose two colors, a bright orange and magenta as the second color. Then we use these two blue handles to adjust the start and end. We move the bright start to the upper left corner, the dark end to the bottom right corner. Awesome. The first thing we animate is the bouncing ball loop. We open the position property of the ball shape, press P, and right click on it to separate the dimensions. We only want to animate the Y position. At the beginning, we set the Y position to 824 pixels, which places it exactly on top of the line. We add a keyframe. At 12 frames, we move it up to, let's say, 300 pixels. At 1 second, we move it down again to 824 pixels. In theory, this is a bouncing ball, maybe, but it doesn't work at all. We need to adjust the timing to make it look smooth and organic. We open the graph editor, select the value graph, and turn these two linear lines into an arc or Bezier curve. We choose the convert vertex tool and drag the handles outwards while holding shift. Let's take a look. Awesome. We close the graph editor again. Next, let's select the three keyframes, copy them, and paste them at 1 second and at 2 seconds. And this is our bouncing ball loop. Creating smooth and organic animations is one of the most important skills to have as a motion designer. Learn to use the tools After Effects provides to adjust the time and the path your shapes take. Learn different techniques and principles to give your objects the illusion of gravity, weight, mass, and flexibility. Simply adding EZEs to your keyframes is not enough. For this mini course, I went through my 20 years of experience to filter out the most valuable tips, tricks, and techniques for you. Knowledge that instantly improves your work. Smooth Animator is your kickstart into smooth and organic animations. Link is in the description. Alright, time to work on the second part, the surprise. We go to 3 seconds in the timeline, select the sphere shape and split the layer. Edit, split layer, or use the shortcut. Then we open the position property again and delete all keyframes. And we rename the layer, sphere small. Next, we reduce the size. In the ellipse path 1 property, we set the size to 75 pixels. Let's adjust the color gradient a bit. Move the start and end back onto the corners. Then let's place it on the floor again. This should be Y862 pixels. And we set keyframes for both properties. Overall, we want the sphere to move to the right. We go to 4 seconds and move the sphere to X1400 pixels. That's the general direction and distance. On its Y, we want it to bounce. We set a Y position keyframe at the beginning. 4 frames later, we move it up to around 710 pixels. 4 more frames later, it is back to 862 pixels. Three frames later, it is up again, around 780 pixels. Three more frames later, back to 862 pixels. 2 frames later, 824 pixels. Roughly. 2 more frames later, 862 pixels. 1 frame later, 848 pixels. 1 frame later, back on the floor, 862 pixels. 1 frame later, 854 pixels. 1 more frame later, back on the floor. The rest of the distance, it rolls on the floor. So time-wise, the steps get shorter. And position-wise, the bounce is less high, because the sphere loses energy over time. And I messed up here, this is supposed to be lower than the first one. We need to adjust the value graph though. We select the Y position keyframes and open the graph editor. And again, we turn these linear lines into Bezier curves using the Convert Vertex tool. Hold Shift while dragging the handles outwards. And this should make a huge difference. It does. The stop here at the end is abrupt. Let's close the graph editor. At 4 seconds and 12 frames, let's move it around 50 pixels further to the right. Then choose the X position and adjust the value graph. We slow down the end by moving this handle to the left while holding Shift and create an overall nice looking curve. Awesome. Let's add a second sphere very quickly. We duplicate the sphere small layer, Command or Control D. Open the position property. We need to add a Y position keyframe below the most right X position keyframe. We select all keyframes and move the time indicator to the beginning at 3 seconds. Then we hold Option if you use a Mac, otherwise Alt, and drag these two most right keyframes to the right to slow down the overall movement. Then let's offset the animation by 1 frame. And as quickly as that, the shape moves in a different way. To make it bounce towards the left instead of the right, we add a null object. Let's move the start point further right. Then we link the sphere 2 shape to the null. Turn the sphere 2 layer and the null into 3D layers. And rotate the null along the y-axis by 180 degrees. That's it. Check out the project file to see how I animated the triangle and the cube. It's the same principle. You could delete the null again now. Make sure to check out the mini course, link is in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.